गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आवर टुडेज चैप्टर इज नंबर सिस्टम्स एंड टॉपिक इज हाउ टू रिप्रेजेंट सम इरेशनल नंबर्स ऑन द नंबर लाइन। बिफोर वी शैल गो टू द टॉपिक, आई वांट टू एक्सप्लेन सम यूजफुल टर्म्स एंड कॉन्सेप्ट्स रिलेटेड टू द टॉपिक। नंबर वन, रियल नंबर। What is real number? A number whose square is not negative number is called real number. In fact, all rational numbers and all irrational numbers together form the collection of real numbers. That is, a real number is either rational or irrational. It means all real numbers can be classified into two classes, and they are rational and irrational. Now I am going to explain rational numbers. What is a rational number? A number which can be expressed in the form p by q, where p and q are integers and q is not equal to 0. For example, 1 by 2, 2 by 3, 3 by 1, 7 by 8, minus 7 by 5, minus 5 by minus 9, etc. are rational numbers. In fact, all natural numbers, whole numbers and all integers are also rational numbers, because these all can be expressed in the form p by q with q equal to 1. In the previous classes, you have already learned how to represent a rational number on the number line, and that's why I am not going to show the representation of rational numbers this time. Now let us go to understand what is irrational number. To understand irrational number, I think we should use the concept of a right angle triangle. Now I am going to draw an isosceles right angle triangle ABC with angle B equal to 90 degree and AB equal to BC equal to 180. This is a right angle triangle. The name of the right angle triangle ABC. This is just a rough sketch of a right angle triangle. The side opposite to angle B is AC, and it is known as the hypotenuse. This is the horizontal side, and that's why it is known as base. This is the vertical side. This is known as perpendicular. And I have drawn an isosceles right angle triangle. That's why AB equal to BC. And I have taken the length of AB and BC as one unit and one unit. And therefore, I am going to write here one unit. And this is also one unit. Let the length of AC be L. By using Pythagoras theorem, we can write AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. Pythagoras theorem states that the square of hypotenuse of a right angle triangle is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides. That's why AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. Now, AC equal to L, therefore L square, here 1 square plus 1 square equal to 1 plus 1 equal to 2. That is, L is equal to root over 2 unit. Now, you can arise a question, what kind of the number root over 2? Is the number root over 2? Is root over 2 रेशनल नंबर आई थिंक इट इज नॉट ए रेशनल नंबर बिकॉज इट इज नॉट इन द फॉर्म पी बाई क्यू वेयर पी एंड क्यू आर इंटीजर्स. इवन वी कैन राइट रूट ओवर टू इन द फॉर्म ऑफ पी बाई क्यू दैट इज रूट ओवर टू बाई वन बट रूट ओवर टू डज नॉट बिलोंग टू द सेट ऑफ इंटीजर्स. वन बिलोंग टू द सेट ऑफ इंटीजर एंड देयरफॉर दिस इज नॉट इन द फॉर्म पी बाई क्यू वेयर पी एंड क्यू आर इंटीजर्स एंड क्यू इज नॉट इक्वल टू जीरो. देयरफॉर इट इज नॉट ए रेशनल नंबर. देन व्हाट इज दिस नंबर? दिस इज इरेशनल. We can find its decimal extension by finding the square root of 2 by long division method. And you have already learned how to find the square root of a positive integer by long division method in the previous class. When you find the square root of 2, then you will get a non-terminating, non-recurring decimal expansion. It means that an irrational number, that is the decimal expansion of irrational number, is non-terminating, non-repeating, that is non-recurring. And therefore we cannot highlight the non-terminating, non-repeating characters of root over 2 or any irrational numbers by measurement on the number line. Now, we can define an irrational number as a number which cannot be written in the form p by q, where p and q are integers and q is not equal to 0, is called irrational number. Examples of irrational numbers: root over 2, root over 3, 1 by root over 2, root over 2 by root over 3, minus root over 2, minus root over 3 by 4, etc. are irrational numbers. Now, two numbers. There are two methods of representation of an irrational number on the number line, and they are a spiral method and number two semicircle method. But all irrational numbers cannot be represented on the number line by using a spiral method. Only a few number of irrational numbers can be represented on the number line by a spiral method. What kind of number can be represented on the number line? What kind of the irrational numbers can be represented on the number line? I think an irrational number which is in the form a plus minus root over b, where a and b are integers and b greater than 0, can be represented on the number line by a spiral method. And I am going to write it and irrational number which is in the form a plus minus root over b, where a, b are integers and b greater than 0, can be represented एग्जाम्पल 0 प्लस माइनस रूट ओवर 2, 0 प्लस माइनस रूट ओवर 3, माइनस 3 प्लस माइनस रूट ओवर 5, 4 प्लस माइनस रूट ओवर 7 एक्सेट्रा आर इन द फॉर ए प्लस माइनस रूट ओवर बी वेयर ए एंड बी आर इंटीजर्स एंड बी ग्रेटर देन 0। इन ए प्लस रूट ओवर ए प्लस माइनस रूट ओवर बी ए इज कॉल्ड रेशनल पार्ट एंड बी रूट ओवर बी इज कॉल्ड इरेशनल पार्ट। नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू शो द पोजिशन ऑफ ए प्लस माइनस रूट ओवर बी ऑन द नंबर लाइन with the help of rough sketch. Let XY be a line O be a point on the line A plus minus root over B. This is the rational part, and that's why O represents A on the number line. I am drawing a line segment. Let the length of this line segment equal to root over B unit. Using compass, we center O and radius equal to root over B. I draw two arcs on both sides of the point O. Let us name these points where the line and arc intersect. Be P and Q. It is obvious that OP equal to root over B unit and OQ equal to root over B unit. We cannot express the length of a line segment in negative sign, because the magnitude of the distance and the length of any line segment cannot be expressed in negative measurement. Thus, P corresponds A plus root over B and Q corresponds A minus root over B on the number line. These are the positions of A plus root over B and A minus root over B on the number line, and this is a point which represents the rational part of A plus B root over B, A plus minus root over B. Now let us see how we can represent some irrational numbers on the number line. To locate plus minus root over 2 and plus minus root over 3 on the number line. In order to locate root over plus minus root over 3, I am going to draw a number line. This is a straight line. I did not use a scale, but whenever you will represent such numbers on the number line, then you will have to use a scale. The name of the line is L here. This side is negative and this is positive side. Let us take a point on it. The name of the point is O. Now, plus minus root over 2 can be expressed as 0 plus minus root over 2. We can write here A equal to 0 and B equal to 2, because I have already explained that an irrational number which is in the form A plus minus root over B can be represented on the number line by a spiral method. And so this is A and root over 2, that is 2 is equal to B. And therefore let O represent 0 on the number line. This is equivalent to A, equal to A, according to A plus minus root over B. If this is 2 minus 3, if you are asked to represent minus 3 plus minus root over 2, then you will have to write here A equal to minus 3, and here you will have to write minus 3. Otherwise, you cannot find the correct answer. Now I am going to take a fixed length, is called unit length, and set of equal distances to right hand as well as left hand of O on the number line. A, B, C, A dash, B dash, C dash are the name of the points on the line. Here A, B, C represent 1, 2, 3 respectively. And A dash, B dash, C dash represent minus 1, minus 2 and minus 3 respectively. Here OA is 1 unit, OB equal to 2 units, OC equal to 3 units, OA dash equal to 1 unit, OB dash 1, 2 units, OC dash 3 units. Clearly OA equal to AB equal to BC, equal to OA dash, equal to A dash, B dash, equal to B set, C dash. Now, I am going to write 2 equal to 1 plus 1. And the sum of the squares, sum of the 2 square natural numbers. Here 1 is a square natural number, 1 is a square number, a square natural number, and 2 is equal to 1 plus 1, but it is not possible for each and every number that the sum of the square natural number will be the number what we will represent on the number line. Like the 7 equal to 3 plus 4. Here 4 is a square number, but 3 is not a square number. 1 plus 6, 1 is a square number, 6 is not a square number. 2 plus 5, both are not a square number. 3 plus 4, 4 is a square number. 5 plus 1, 5 is not a square number. And 1 is a square number. It means that this is not true for all kind of the number, that all numbers can be expressed as the sum of 2 square natural number. Now I am going to use the concept of Pythagoras theorem, and for this I am going to draw an isosceles right angle triangle OAB, in which angle A equal to 90 degree and OA equal to AB equal to 1 unit and 1 unit. Let the length of OB be L. By Pythagoras theorem, we can write OB square equal to OA square. I have already explained what is Pythagoras theorem. L square 1 square plus 1 square, 1 plus 1 equal to 2, therefore L is equal to root over 2 unit. This is the positive root over 2. Because the length cannot be measured in negative sign, so L is equal to root over 2 unit. The same concept will be used to represent root over 2 on the number line. Now, I am going to take OA on the number line as 1 unit and draw AB perpendicular on OA. Here, I am going to use sec square. You can use protractor also to draw perpendicular. Let AX be the perpendicular on OA. Using compass, we will cut AB from AX equal to 1 unit, means OA equal to AB. Join OB. This is a right angle triangle with angle OAB equal to 90 degree. This is congruent to this triangle. And by using this concept, we can write the length of OB equal to root over 2 unit. Now, using compass, we center O and radius OB. We draw an arc which intersects the line at two different points, P on the right hand side of O and Q on the left side of O. Clearly, OB equal to OP equal to OQ equal to root over 2 units. Because OB equal to OP equal to OQ are the radii. OB, OP and OQ are the radii of the arc what we have drawn with the center O and the radius OB. Thus, the points P and Q corresponds to root over 2 and minus root over 2 on the number line L. That's why we will mark here I root over 2 and this is minus root over 2. And so in this way we can represent root over 2 and minus root over 2 on the number line. If you are asked to represent only root over 2, then you do not need to represent minus root over 2 on the line. Generally, you will be asked to represent root over 2 on the number line. Now, I am going to use the same concept to represent plus minus root over 3 on the number line. Now, plus minus root over 3 equal to 0 plus minus root over 3. So, this is A and this is root over B. That is A equal to 0 and B equal to 3. So, we have already mention here that the 0 is the representation of the point O on the number line. That is, the point O represents 0 on the number line. 3 equal to 1 plus 2, that is 2 plus 1. We cannot express as the sum of another two natural numbers. Here, 1 is the square number, but 2 is not a square natural number. And therefore, we can write it root over 2 whole square plus 1 square. Now, once again, I am going to use the concept of right angle triangle. And here, I am going to draw a right angle triangle OBC, where OB equal to root over 2 units, BC equal to 1 unit, and angle B equal to 90 degree. This is just a rough sketch of a right angle triangle OBC. This is root over 2, this is 1 unit, this is 90 degree, and this is the hypotenuse L, that is OC. By using Pythagoras theorem, once again we write L square, that is OC square equal to OB square plus BC square. This implies L square equal to root over 2 square plus 1 square. This is equal to 2 plus 1 equal to 3. Therefore, L is equal to root over 3 units. In this right angle triangle, OB equal to root over 2, BC equal to 1, and therefore L square equal to root over 2 square plus 1 square equal to 2 plus 1 equal to 3, therefore L is equal to root over 3. Now I am going to draw another right angle triangle by taking OB equal to root over 2 units, and I shall draw here BC perpendicular on OB. And then we will join OC and OC will give root over 3. The length of OC will give root over 3. And so, without wasting any time, I am going to construct a right angle triangle with one side OB on the figure. Here once again I am going to use the set square. It is easy to use with respect to protractor. This is perpendicular on OB. Let us name the perpendicular on OB as OY. We cut one unit from BY and let us name this point as C, which is one unit. Join OC this is 90 degree by following this one we can say this is equal to root over 3 once again using compass and radius using compass and we center O and radius OC. I am going to draw another arc which intersects the line at two different point. One is on the right side of O and another is on the left side of O. Let us name of the point as P dash and Q dash. Clearly P dash represents root over 3 and Q dash represents minus root over 3. And OC equal to, because OC equal to OP dash equal to OQ dash equal to root over 3. Thus the points P dash and Q dash corresponds to root 3 on the number line. Actually, when you will be asked to represent root over 3 on the number line, then you will have to represent root over 2 also. Without representing root over 2, you cannot represent root over 3 on the number line. And now I am going to show one more question. Representation of an irrational number on the number line. To locate minus 3 plus minus root over 5 on the number line. In order to represent this one, let us draw a line on the line O. Here O will represent 3. This point O will represent 3 because this is the rational part. This is equal to A and this is equal to B. Now by taking the unit length, I am going to set up distances to both sides, that is on to right hand side and left hand side. This is 4, 5, 6. This is 2, 1, and this is 0. This is 1 unit. 1 unit. OB equal to 2 unit. OC equal to 3 unit. Similarly, this is 1 unit, 2 units, and 3 unit. Now,
and hence
the points P and Q corresponds to 3 plus root over 5 and 3 minus root over 5 on the number line. Today only this much. See you in the next class for the rest. Thank you.